It's where all the fairy tale characters really live. Abracadabra, Simsala Grim.
As important as he thinks.
He's the emperor.
Well, I guess that makes him as important as he thinks. I'm taking a closer look.
Wait!
How shabbily the poor people dress. Little wonder they admire my costume so.
It is the most wondrous things the wretches have ever seen, Majesty.
But does it show the remarkable imperial physique to excellent advantage, Prime Minister?
Very much so, Majesty. Now, may we please discuss the upcoming visit by the Queen of Nextland?
This costume is too plain. Ordinary. The most important thing in the world is to be noticed and admired for your appearance.
Without doubt, Majesty.
How silly and vain.
Hey, he's the Emperor. Why shouldn't he do what he likes?
Because these people pay for all of it in taxes.
Okay, that's a pretty good why shouldn't he.
Peasants born. I want a better costume. I want the most amazing suit of new clothes.
Never me! Majesty, the Queen of Nextland is coming and...
Oh, the Queen of Nextland. She's such a bore. She knows nothing of fashion.
Oh, no.
Destiny, genius, this hat, those bells.
I beg your pardon?
See, Majesty? Two repulsive creatures made acceptable with a few well-placed accessories.
Repulsive? I am Doc Croc, scholar, philosopher.
Yeah. And I'm Yo-Yo, the greatest adventurer since... Hello? Those nimble little fingers. Majesty, I give you your new designers.
Designers?
Sure, you heard the man. We're repulsive.
Some charities for the poor have asked for an audience, Majesty.
Charities? The poor? Ugh. When the poor start dressing a little better, I'll start caring a little more. I love my lake. It is the great big watery mirror for me to enjoy my many pretty expressions.
Yes, Majesty, about the Queen's visit.
Can't you see I'm busy? Quickly, Jean-Paul, the blue hat. I can't believe how pretty I am today. I am having such a pretty day.
The Queen arrives next Thursday?
Yes, Thursday. And she wants to negotiate about the Western lands.
Imperial designers?
Uh-huh.
Your fabulous costume must be ready for next Thursday's procession.
Thursday. But that's next Thursday.
And it had better be next Thursday's fashions.
Garters are in fashion today.
Garters?
No! Too late! They're in fashion today. You have to give me a costume that's in fashion next Thursday.
But how are we supposed to know what's in fashion next Thursday?
Exactly.
Oh, dear me, what now?
What now? Genius! That's what now! Hey! Hey! Yay! Yes!
Oh, no!
What did I tell you? Genius!
And 4 days early, too.
I've never seen anything quite like it. Jean-Paul?
It is certainly most irregular, sir. Très avant-garde.
Daring? New? But does it show the remarkable imperial physique to excellent advantage?
It does not, sir.
Huh? Uh-huh.
And it will not be in fashion next Thursday or ever. Is this supposed to be a hat? Preposterous.
Hey, say what you like about the rest, but this hat was an all-nighter.
Who are you people? How dare you enter my dressing room?
How embarrassing. They do not know who we are.
How gauche we must seem.
May I present Mrs. Swindleson, the finest creator and manipulator of fabrics upon the globe.
And may I introduce Mr. Swindleson, the world's greatest fashion designer and inventor of the ruffled collar.
Ooh la la! I adore a well-ruffled collar.
Who doesn't?
Magnificent! Splendid! Exactly right! Remarkable! Mrs. Swindleson, I think we might be able to do it.
Do what?
Make you a suit of clothes.
We want to make you a very, very special suit.
Hold in the tummy, please. I am holding in the tummy.
This suit will have an entirely singular property. You tell them, Mr. Swindleson, I cannot.
The suit shall be completely invisible to people who are unforgivably foolish and to anyone who does not deserve their job.
Ooh.
I must have it. I must have this suit. Do you hear?
Does this mean we're going to be fired?
No, 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 my little darlings. You are fired as soon as these two walked in the door.
Oh.
120 kilos of gold, 100 meters of Florentine velvet, 86 meters of antique Chinese silk.
Wow, this outfit's gonna weigh a ton.
Oh, really? Come on, how can you possibly need 58 kilos of pearls?
Prime Minister, give them everything they need. No quibbles.
So this outfit will really be invisible to fools, huh?
Invisible to fools and those unworthy of their position.
Everyone else will have a vision to remember their whole lives.
Oh.
I can't wait!
Huh. The fashion designer's life, huh? This morning, imperial appointment. Tonight, sleeping in the yard like dogs.
Not exactly like dogs.
Well, no one could say the Swindlesons don't put in the hours, huh?
What's that?
Creeping about in the middle of the night.
I don't know, but something stinks.
It's not my fault. In case you haven't noticed, there isn't exactly a bathtub of perfume back there.
So, when negotiating with the Queen of Nextland, you must maintain a dignified air. One hint of weakness, and she'll have a claim on the Western lands.
A fabric that is invisible to fools. I want to see it. I must see it. I will be able to see it, won't I, Jean-Paul?
But of course, Your Majesty is so very wise and most worthy to be Emperor.
Yes, yes, I am. Lift that mirror. I so enjoy my thinking expression.
Yo-Yo, a little help.
Oh, you're doing fine, Doc. Great job. Real proud of you.
Okay.
I know. Prime Minister, you shall go to the weaving room for me and report back on the fabric's progress.
Me, Your Majesty?
You are my Prime Minister, and you are worthy of your position, are you not?
Thank you, Majesty. It'll be an honor.
Prime Minister, I'm sure you're no fool.
And I'm sure you are most worthy of your position.
Behold!
I'm quite speechless.
Exquisite, is it not? Why, only look, Prime Minister. Feel, feel! At once like velvet, yet also somehow like silk, is it not?
Well, it's, I must say, it's remarkable.
Oh, well said, sir, indeed. And you don't think it is too dark?
Oh, no, not at all. It's most certainly anything but too dark.
We'll need a lot more of that Florentine velvet. As you can see, we're simply flying through the stuff.
Quickly, the mirror! I look so alive when I'm excited. Mm-hmm. Now, Prime Minister, your news.
The fabric is a triumph of design and art. It's a modern wonder and a masterpiece.
I knew it! I knew it!
I still don't see any fabric.
Oh, so you must be a fool, right?
Could be. What is it? Huh?
Sunlight plays over the fabric's patterns as over a lake at sunset.
I can't bear it!
And the ruffled collar is the finest I have ever ruffled. Please, Majesty, come and see the progress.
No. Jean-Paul, you go.
Very well, Majesty.
We'll go with you.
It's coming along, eh?
I have never seen anything like it.
And over there, the completed waistcoat.
On the dummy. Oh, It is inspired.
Yes, and it is over there.
And how light to wear it shall be. And such delicate patterns. The pants are just the right length.
And the shoes. You don't think they're too much, do you?
Too much? Why, the Emperor shall hardly know he is wearing them. So, Doc, what do you think?
I haven't quite made up my mind, Yo-Yo.
The suit is a triumph of design and art, a modern wonder and a masterpiece.
I can hardly contain myself. And you, little Doc Croc?
Your Majesty, I think the Swindlesons are trying to swindle you. I believe the whole thing is a trick.
And the Emperor, such an ugly thing.
But if you just come to the weaving room, I'll show you.
Enough! I'll hear no more from you today. Jean-Paul, tell me more. Is there a hat?
Majesty, there has never been a hat such as this.
And you really think you saw something, Yo-Yo?
Hey, I wish I had a suit just like it.
Well, that's the thing. I think you do.
Huh? Mm-hmm. Ah!
Velvet. Do not ask where it comes from. You will get a very good price for it at the market.
Thank you, nice lady.
Everyone in the district is so grateful for your generosity these past nights. You are all very welcome.
The Swindlesons are giving away all the materials.
Yes, they are.
Then what are they making the Emperor's suit from?
That'll come to you.
We'll have a procession on Thursday when he greets the Queen of Nextland, and he will wear a suit.
A suit that is completely invisible to fools.
And invisible to anyone unworthy of their position.
We're meeting the Queen of Nextland in 1 hour, and we've made no preparations at all.
None is needed. I will be wearing the most amazing costume ever made. Mirror! My winning smile. The Queen will be silenced with envy at my costume, and I will demand the Western lands on the spot. Simple. Jean-Paul, I am ready. Bring me my new clothes.
Mrs. Swindleson, as you modestly predicted, the Emperor is speechless.
The greatest praise of all, Mr. Swindleson. May I set these down, Majesty? They are very heavy.
Huh? Ready with the coat, Mrs. Swindleson.
When you are, Mr. Swindleson.
Very well. This way, Majesty.
So, here it is. What say you, Prime Minister?
Quite unbelievable, Majesty.
Jean-Paul?
It's... I can hardly look, Majesty.
So, Yo-Yo, you still like the suit?
There is no suit. Oh, wow.
Do be careful, Majesty. You almost stepped on your hat.
Hmm. Does it show the remarkable imperial physique to excellent advantage?
Without a doubt.
Most definitely.
And it is today's fashion.
I can assure your majesty that this suit will never go out of fashion.
Very well. Let the procession begin.
Little friend.
Thank you for not giving the game away.
I tried, but the Emperor wouldn't listen.
So, you showed the Emperor for what he really is.
And you helped out the poor people of the town.
And we have more to do.
Wow, the Emperor really should have stuck with us as his designers.
Which reminds me, Yo-Yo, would you mind if I kept this? It's simply the most darling hat.
Oh, sure. It suits you.
He was so obsessed with how he looked and what people thought of his clothes, he never saw those guys coming.
So what's really in your heart is way more important than your image, right?
If you can't see the clothes, it means you're a fool.
What a splendid suit of clothes! His best ever!
What's more, the filthy rabble are amazed by my appearance amongst them.
And more amazing than ever, Majesty.
Whoa!
He's in the nude! Look, everyone! The Emperor isn't wearing a stitch!
Shh, darling. People will think we're fools.
We might be fools, but we're not foolish enough to walk around the streets buck naked!
Your Majesty, may I present the Queen of Nextland.
Welcome, Queen of Nextland. What think you of my costume?
I think, sir, that it shows you exactly as you are.
What is the meaning of this laughter? My costume? It's my best ever, isn't it?
Majesty, I'm afraid there is no costume.
It seems we've been swindled by the Swindlesons, Majesty.
We shall consider the matter of the Western lands settled, I suppose.
Time to go, Yo-Yo. Simsa!
Simsala!
Simsala Graham!
And they all lived happily ever after.